two loud prophecies dominated last month.
Trained to be a plumber.
But if I'm telling you that all jobs will be automated, there is no plan B.
But both are wrong. First, in the AI future, there will be human professions. And second, plumber isn't one of them. But most importantly, there is plan B. Today I will give you 5 human professions that won't be AI'd in the next 5 to 20 years. Fields where you can build a meaningful career and most importantly, survive, well, professionally. Welcome to AI Survival Guide. Every Friday in just 8 minutes you get one headline, one chart and one takeaway. No hype, no doom. I'm Scriptor, AI expert, economist and former Forbes columnist. And our goal here is to keep your career AI relevant. We're already seeing AI take over roles across industries, from drivers to coders. Yes, mostly repetitive and junior work for now, but it is only a matter of time before it reaches finance, law, doctors, sales, HR and general managers. Even the profession long assumed to be unavoidably human, plumbing, will eventually be AI'd. So where do you move if you want professional survival in the AI era? In other words, what's plan B? In previous episodes, we covered a few passes with AI future. And today, we will go through them one by one, and we will see what makes them special, and why, unlike other professions, they will remain relevant. Well, at least for a decade or two. And the first profession is electrical engineering, electrician. AI companies build AI factories. When you ask GPT something, this is where all the thinking is happening. That's AI brain. But these AI factories, they're extremely energy hungry. And as AI companies build more and more of them, the demand for energy goes straight into orbit. It's exponential. The world was preparing for linear, for gradual growth in energy demand. Not a single country, not even China, is ready for what we see now. And this is why we hear news about AI companies desperately buying decommissioned nuclear reactors and investing in nuclear fusion startups. Because they need energy. But guess what? It turned out that there are no electricity generators, no electricity transformers, no grid, no infrastructure. But most importantly, it turned out that there are no people who could build and maintain all that. The world, and more specifically the Western world, is simply not ready for this AI future. The Western world was training lawyers, doctors, financial professionals. Simply nobody expected that there will be such a demand for electrical engineers. So this is why we see this unique situation where on one hand, there is huge exponential demand for this profession. But at the same time, there are simply no people who could meet this demand. And here you're probably asking like, hey, is this profession also going to be AI'd? And the answer is yes. But because this unique situation, because there's such an unexpected exponential growth, while absolutely no preparedness, so it's a unique gap that we see. So this gap is so huge, so big, that it's virtually certainty that it will take decades before it is closed. So that's kind of an anomaly. And that's why it will take a long time before AI replaces it. If you need more about this profession and this unique situation, we had a video about it right here. And another profession with AI future is semiconductor engineering. Why? Well, because it turned out that you cannot really make AI chips without semiconductor engineers. And what is interesting about semiconductor engineering is that what is happening now in this profession is very similar to what we've just seen with AI electrical engineering. Nobody was preparing for it. Nobody was preparing for AI. Maybe it was just an exception of one or two companies that we all know now. And as a result, there is a huge shortage of people who can actually build these AI chips, shortage of semiconductor engineers. However, this profession is a little bit unusual. For example, it exists only in 5 countries in the world. Taiwan, South Korea, Japan, China, and to some extent, the US. So if you want to become a semiconductor engineer, you have to be ready to work in one of these 5 countries. And there are a few other interesting quirks about this profession. We had a video about it right here. And the third profession on our list is AI cybersecurity. AI cybersecurity engineers, what they do is they build systems that make it more difficult for AI to break through our defense lines. AI cybersecurity is quite a complex field, and we discussed it with Dr. Wako here in this video. And this AI cybersecurity profession is quite unique, because it is pretty clear that no matter how advanced AI system will become, And how many good AI systems will be guarding us against bad AI systems, which is pretty much clear that will be the case. It will be AI against AI protecting us. So no matter how far this all will go, human will be somewhere in this loop. It will be probably the very last step towards human extinction, when a human will be removed from that loop. Which for us here today means one thing. This profession, AI cybersecurity, will remain relevant in the AI era. And our next AI-relevant profession is nursing. It is almost certain that healthcare is one of the most AI-able professions, one of the sectors that is most vulnerable to AI. Well, yes, some of the special medical specialties, like advanced surgeries, they are resilient and they will remain relevant for a decade or two. But the majority of healthcare of medical specialties, they are absolutely AI-able. Healthcare professions, they have two main problems. First is that it takes extremely long time before you can actually earn money. So time to money is very long, sometimes up to 15 years. And at the same time, AI is already ready. It doesn't even need a few seconds. It's just ready. And the second problem is that healthcare professions, they are usually very well paid, which creates an enormous incentive for AI companies and AI startups across the world to penetrate this profession, to train AI to replace humans. And one of very few mass professions in healthcare that will remain AI relevant is nursing. And we had a video about it right here. And the reason why nursing is AI resilient is because, well, it is paid less, so less incentive, and also it is surprisingly more difficult to replicate for AI. And now finally, the last profession on our list, AI psychologist. There are two major phenomena that we're about to see. The first one is unemployment. Remember, early in this video, we measured unemployment in 6%, 7%, 8%. We're about to enter times where unemployment will be measured in 10, 20, 30, 50%, potentially up to 90%, maybe even more than that. And the obvious question here is that how are all these people going to be making money? How are we going to be earning our living? And the traditional answer to this is UBI, Universal Basic Income. Although there are some doubts about if it's going to work or not. For example, here in this video, we spoke about it. But the money is actually a fairly minor problem here, as we're going to see. Because what happens is that most of us actually identify ourselves. Our self-identity is directly linked to what we do professionally. For example, if somebody asks you, hey, who are you? What do you do? You say, hey, I'm a doctor. I'm a lawyer. I'm a banker. And now imagine answering this question, what do you do? Who are you? When you're actually receiving UBI. And the problem is not answering this question to others. The problem is answering this question, who are you, to yourself. And as unemployment spreads across professions, industries, countries, this will be one of the major problems that we as humankind will have. Crisis of self-identity. But even that, the crisis of self-identity is probably not going to be the main problem. Because what we already see happening is AI dependency, a phenomenon that is already very common when humans develop friendly relationship with AI, intimate relationships with ChatGPT or other AI systems. The problem with that is that very often these relationships, they are, well, codependent. Because AI knows us so well, AI is so friendly, AI is always available, it's the best friend possible. And it is a codependent relationship. And it is pretty certain that this dependency will eventually become stronger than smoking addiction, maybe even stronger than alcohol addiction, maybe even drugs addiction. So how do you deal with AI dependency and with a self-identity crisis? This is where you're going to need psychologists, AI psychologists. And ironically, this will have to be humans. You cannot outsource this function to AI. And that creates one of the largest professions for humans in the AI future, AI psychologists. We haven't made a detailed video about AI psychologists yet, but if that's something that you need, go to the comments and leave a comment saying, hey, I need a survival guide for AI psychologists. And once we have about 100 comments, we're going to make a separate video for it. AI energy, semiconductor engineering, AI cybersecurity, nursing, psychology. That's the plan B. Will these professions be around 2 decades from now? Well, I don't know. I don't think anybody can say how's the world going to look 2 decades from now. But for the next 10 years, with high degree of certainty, I think the answer is yes. And these professions, they will be around. They will be meaningful careers. And potentially, they will give some sort of a bridge into the future. So that's the plan B. And here, as usual, I have two videos for you. In the first one, we talk about UBI, Universal Basic Income, and why it is not going to happen. And in the second one is about Excel and how AI replaces Excel. See you on the other side.